Hello, everybody. Got some new fancy tricks figuring out this OBS stuff. How's it going, everybody? My name is Will Robson. I'm a comic book artist, and today we are doing another live stream. Now, let me fix my camera, because I think the last stream, I didn't catch a lot of what I was drawing, so let me try and get a bit closer. Should have done this in the beginning, but ah, well. You know how it be. Let's turn a light on. Boom, there we go. How's it going? Alright, so today we are doing a suggestion stream, so please just straight up suggest what I should be drawing on this little sketch card. I already know I'm going to be pulling it towards myself a bit more, so should be good. There's my pen going to get in the way a little bit. That should be okay. So tell me what I should draw. What should I draw? You need to tell me. You need to tell me. Is this working? Yeah, it's working. Star-Lord? Alright, let's draw Star-Lord. Let me get up some reference. Star-Lord. Do-do-do. Star-Lord comic. I'm looking with this slick back here. Alright, let's draw some Star-Lord. It's the first book I actually ever was on was a Star-Lord book. I did a filler in for like 15 pages or something like that in 2016, and shortly after that I was on Great Lakes Avengers. And funnily enough, like, that Star-Lord work is, I would say, some of my best work, because, you know, I was really focused and putting my all into it to make sure that I'd be able to land another gig. So let's try and think about eye placement. Like so. I may need to get out some tools for this. So he's got these lenses like this. I'll be back in the chat in just a minute. I just need to look at the reference whilst I'm penciling. I really need to sort of get up a separate device, actually. Do you know what I can do? I can get up on the computer at Star-Lord Comics. Let's try and find that reference image I was using right there. So excuse me one second. That's a bit bad quality. That didn't work out. Alright, never mind. We'll sort that out on a different stream. I'll get that going at some point, because I feel bad that I'm not here to answer questions as I'm going. I wonder if there's a way I can just have like the chat somehow going over the stream. That'd be pretty cool. I'm still learning everything. Learning the old ins and outs. So his mask is pretty complicated. So this may take a second longer to do than my usual. Hope everyone's having a good day. Really enjoyed having Heather on yesterday. That was fun. It's a shame she had to go early, but it was still a good time. It's got this going on here. Oh, who made this Who made this mask so complicated? I mean, really. The poor comic artist that had to draw it. I only had to draw the mask once because in the book, Kitty Pryde was wearing it in one scene. I'm going to take some creative liberties with this as well to make it not exactly accurate. Then he's kind of come down into like almost like a stormtrooper thing going on at the bottom here. Takes a while to draw masks. Faces are different. You can just straight up just get in there. You know how to draw a face. You've drawn a face a million times. But when you do something like this, it's a bit complicated. But it's a good challenge to sort of remind yourself. You know, it's something different. So thank you for the suggestion. So I've been playing a lot of FIFA today. But I've been getting destroyed today online, so I've had to stop because it's actually made me... I've been getting angry and I've been in like a bad mood because I've just let so many easy goals away. So I've stopped. I've worked a bit on my game, Dino Zombies. I've worked on a commission a little bit. And yeah, it's been pretty chill day. It's been a pretty chill day. This is a cool mask, though. I assume this was a design for the movie, and then incorporated into the comics. Because I know he used to have a completely different look, as I recall correctly. At the bottom here, he's got a little sort of chin guard. So again, I'm not going for screen accuracy or anything like that. I'm just doing my own thing with it. I know Stella has more blonde hair in the comics, so we're gonna go with that. Please feel free to ask any questions whilst I'm just doing the pencils so I can hop in and answer them when I'm done doing this stage. And I will happily answer anything you want me to. So there's his slicked back hair. What do you want to do with this neck? Just roughing in the layout lines for a body. I think you get a good idea where to put everything else. I'll definitely do a cosmic style background, and then let's also get that gun in there as well. Oh, that's why that reference was bad. So it's using a low quality image. Or is the gun maybe too much? I don't know. So, oh my god, he's so complicated. Like, his, even his jacket is like a bit, trendier and different style. Style. This is all the figuring out stage where you want stuff to go. Nope, don't like that either. You know what? I struggle with collars. I really do. I always have. For some reason, collars and jackets. It's never been an easy thing for me. And jackets in general. I need to study up on them. Now I'm going to take creative liberties. I'm just designing my own sort of jacket. And I'm kind of just thinking like he's kind of wearing essentially the same thing that Gambit wears. Sometimes I find it easier, even when drawing characters, to think about other characters and then change just certain details about them to make them fit. Alright, he's also got a strap over his shoulder, so let's put that underneath his big jacket. Oops, knocked the camera again. Strap and then a buckle. Full of strap like that. Again, I'm going to add some extra details just to make it my own and make it fit the piece. And then he's got a t-shirt on, so let's put a collar. I guess there would be quite the shadow underneath his neck because it's quite a big mask. Here, I'm starting to do a bit more shadow in the pencil stage as well, just so my brain can process stuff. I've been learning recently, I've been leaving too little detail out in certain spots where I really actually needed extra detail for me to make the finished piece look the way I want it to. Jacket here. of little extra sort of designs on it, so I'm just adding a few extra little designs to make it feel like the trendy jacket it is. Let's actually connect those lines. Nope, shouldn't have connected that. It's so funny, like, since I'm a digital artist, like, and that's how I'm so used to being able to move stuff around and play with stuff, flip images, so it's been really interesting now working traditionally and the amount of limitations that there are when you work traditionally. It's crazy. I'm just going to put in here the tip of his gun. Need a good reference for his gun. Star-Lord gun, just so that adds a little extra detail to the piece. There's lots of side views. I need a sort of three-quarter view. They're very cool guns. Space for this gun that we've now put in here. And you know, if I was doing this professionally, I'd properly be referencing and making sure everything's perfect using proper perspective methods to ensure that what I'm drawing is going to be in the right perspective. But these are all doodles. This is the whole point of this, is just to have some quick art, some quick fun. Now, that should be good. Okay, let's get back in the chat. Sorry that took so long. Let's see. Draw Ice from Justice League International. Sounds cool. Should make sure you suggest that for another suggestion stream. When is Kenobi for the 6-carat sketches? That will be, I believe, Friday. That's when I'll be doing Hello There. 15 Pages of Fame. You did good stuff. 15 Pages of Fame? Oh, right. The Star-Lord book. Thanks. Have you ever drawn Star-Lord's helmet from Annihilation? Sir, it would be cool to see. Is that the original one where it sort of almost comes out a bit? Because that would be fun too. Do you ever get scared that you won't be able to go back into routine post-quarantine? No, I'll be fine. I keep myself very busy. I have been relaxing a bit, but I'll be good. And I'll be looking forward to it as well, because it'll be only money. Thoughts on the upcoming What If series from Disney Plus? T'Challa as Star-Lord is an episode. Sounds great. The Marvel What If comic series has always been my favorite, and it's the one thing I would definitely like to write for, because I feel like it's the most fun. You get to really create stories that are interesting and different and sort of break the mold a bit, and you can get away with anything because
Now there's no limitations. I haven't looked into episode descriptions or what stuff is yet, but I'd be very interested to see what people come up with. Quarantine is where I've made my routine. No job, no responsibility. Might as well get my drawing routine check. Yeah, well, you know what? I said I'm going to keep myself very busy, and I did that to start with. And then I did make a point to myself to say, look, you're never going to get this amount of time again just to relax. It's almost like being like when you're back at school and young and you don't need a job or anything, and it's just summer holiday, and the only thing you can do is play video games because you can't go outside and hang out. So I've been making sure to just do a bit of R&R, which I've been doing the past week or so, and it's really helped me just be like, right, I'm now ready to start working on my art, etc. and stuff like that. Sorry, I was concentrating. Again, as I'm inking, I'm just taking a bit more creative liberties with drawing. I love the little South Park reference there when you said Stoyle. What's your Stoyle? So weird. Like, I watch something and then it will become just a part of my regular vocabulary. Like, I said something before. I said, if I recall correctly, which is from the outtakes from Eastbound and Down of Will Ferrell, and he says, if I recall correctly. And for some reason, that's the moment I heard that, my brain was like, yep, we're going to say that like that for the rest of our lives. So we're keeping this very sketchy. Quick lines. Yeah, it's more soldier looking helmet. Yeah, it definitely is. It's still, yeah, it's cool though. I like them both. Really like the Guardians of the Galaxy movie. It was, for a while, it was my favorite Marvel movie. Oops, I just dropped a dot on the page. Luckily, it's in a spot I can cover up. For a while, I was like, this is my favorite Marvel movie. But then a little movie called Thor Ragnarok came out, and that trumped it for me. Oops, whacked the camera again. Get my show on screen. Do you have any favorite What If books? Was the Marvel Zombies, was that technically a What If? Because I loved Marvel Zombies. I haven't read too many What If stories. I think is Punisher Kills Marvel Universe, is that a What If story? If you know any synopsis or any recommendations, then please share. I know they came out recently with a new What If series, didn't they? Like, I think there was, like, What If Flash Thompson Became Spider-Man? What If Magic was Doctor Strange and all that type of stuff. I love it. I love all that stuff. And is there one What If that you'd love to do? Well, me and my brother were working on a story called The Retired Once, which was all based on Kingpin basically getting rid of all superheroes by doing really messed up stuff. Like he surgically removed Cyclops' eyes so he couldn't use his powers anymore. He chopped off Quicksilver's legs, and like he had a big trophy room full of all of these things that he'd done. And he was the president of the United States. And he used, he had Hulk on retainer as essentially an atom bomb. So if anybody messed with America, he could just send the Hulk out and destroy their country. And it was pretty messed up. But I like messed up stuff. Messed up stuff is fun. But I'd be happy working on any Marvel What If book. I think this is just, like I said, there's something fresh about it. Let's change pens here. It's my pens like this. Oh, I feel like I'm about to sneeze. Kitty Pryde in the Star-Lord outfit was the first ever Marvel character I drew as a Marvel comic book artist. opening to issue that issue was a splash page of her speaking with the collector. Sorry for the sniffling, and my hay fever's kicked in. Oh, jeez. Hay fever! So I currently only have one commission on the board right now. So if anybody would like to get a commission from me, please email me at robsonrequest@gmail.com. Because I'm pretty much fully open, besides just one big one I currently have. And I think I'm in the process of selling another one currently, which has to do with Spider-Man the Animated Series. Okay, is there anything I'm missing from this drawing? I want to move to colors. Oh yeah, half the drawing and it's not done yet. What a dingus. I would very much enjoy drawing a Guardians of the Galaxy book. I love the characters, I love space. So I think that would be a treat for me, I think. So like I said, if this was me professionally doing it, I wouldn't just be freehanding all this stuff. I would have done all the perspective and roughed it out. Made sure that what I was drawing was exactly in the best perspective it could possibly be. But we're just having fun. So again, if there's any more questions, please just let me know. Some rendering in. Some extra shadow. Pretty much done with these eggs. Sorry that I'm not too talkative. Whew! Been really just concentrating on getting the inks nice for this. Okey-dokey, so there's our inks. Still, actually, I got a few more inks I need to do. There we go. Now we need to erase, and I gotta make sure that I don't freaking do the thing I usually do. I gotta make sure I just erase one way, otherwise if I go back and forth, then I can scrunch up the sketch card and potentially put big old damage on it, so we don't want to do that. Go. So ink's there. Alright, let me hop back in the chat. My chat's frozen. Oh wow, my chat froze. Technically Zombies is an alternate dimension series, not part of What If books. Okay, gotcha. I have a bunch, including What If Tony sold out and gave the suits to the US military. Oh, that sounds really interesting. I like that idea. Punisher was an agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. Interesting. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. It's a bit too yellow, that yellow I just used. Let's try and bring some of that blonde back in. I seem to always go just canary yellows for everything. I need to tone it back, baby. Tone it back. It's definitely more blonde. I need to do a bit. There we go. Nice golden locks. And a lot of Spidey what ifs, yeah. I'd love to see a really meta what if book at some point, like a reverse Gordon Cool where superheroes brought into our real world. Yeah, that'd be cool. Anytime you crinkle paper, you're gonna go, now that's a lot of damage. What's that from? What is that from? From okay, I need to get the reference back up again because I need to color and I don't know the colors of everything. Does have red eyes, I got that part down. Okay, it's a very sort of, right, let's try tease for the gray. Should we go a bit darker than that to start? Let's start with a T5. T5, baby. And I just want the lighting from above. Nice, simple. Lining from above. So I don't think I'm going to be super talkative on this one because I'm concentrating. So just, you know what? Just enjoy the art. Enjoy the lovely art. How about that? Because this one so far, I think it's turning out pretty good. That was a T5, so let's then go down to a T3. With the next layer of color. So when I say T5 and T3, basically these Copics, the numbers as they go down, they go lighter. So the higher the number, generally the darker the tone. So as I go down and down, it will get lighter and lighter. So I'm going to go to a T1 now. So, I've missed a little spot, so let's get back to the T5. Going back over with the T5 just to darken the spots again that the lighter tones took out. Trying to keep it shiny, make sure that light's reflective, and then I'm going to add a little B000 into it just because it gives it that little steel look. And that's another Todd Nock trick. I've seen him use it for things like Colossus. Gives it a little extra oomph of shade, so it's not just completely black and white. And I like it a very much. It's very nice. Okay, I need some sort of... He's got a bit of gold yellow. So let's make this all gold yellow. Oops, I forgot to do the colors around his eyes. T1, this is a B000000000, like so. Alright, the gold. Oh, but we want to keep it separate from the hair, so let's make it a bit orangey so that it is not too similar, and then let's darken it down with a warm 3. Actually, that went too dark, so let's try and line it up with a bit of yellow. And that's pretty good. Maybe I'll go one more yellow. Let's go one more yellow. Yellow 2. There we go, that's the color I was thinking. There we go. Back to orange a bit, and then we need to add some shading, so I'll grab a W4. So. There needs to be a bit more shading on the mask, so let's take a cool 4. go. It looks like Stoller basically needs a new helmet because it's a bit rusty, which is fine. Okay, so let's get some skin color on his neck because he's got an exposed neck. This is an E11, which I like to start with. To a R20, which adds a little bit of sort of pigment into it, the red, another Todd Knot trick. And then let's wash it all out with an E00, which is a very light brown. And then I need to go back in with the E1111 because I missed a spot under his neck. And then we'll take a W3. To add shadow. Then I'm going to take a darker W, a W7 for this, these renderings I've done here, just to really nail home that there is some darkness in there. That's actually a bit too much. Let's try and bleed out that color. The piece. I guess that'll do. I didn't like that. Oh well. Let me try and bring a bit of the E1111 back in because this is now a bit too dark. And it's ruined. The whole thing's ruined. No, it's fine. Bring the pink back in just so that it doesn't look. And a bit of the E00. So his neck's a bit darker than I intended, but whatever, that's fine. Okay, brown on his little thing here. A little bit of brown there. Let's take a lighter brown. Like that. Come on, you. And then let's take a darker brown. Add some shadow. Light brown back and wash out those colors a bit. Ooh, that's dark. Making mistakes. We're making lots of mistakes. We're ruining the piece of art. We're making mistakes. Gray shirt. Just put that in there like that. That was a W2. This is a W3. And then his jacket is the orangey red. So now I'll go back to the chat. Flex tape / seal. I don't know what you're talking about there. So let's start with some R29. The shadow of his jacket. where the damage quote is from. Oh, right.
I ain't seen it. I have not seen it.
Let's take an R27. Is it the lighter tone for the jacket?
And then an R24
for an even lighter tone of the jacket.
Little bits that we had stuck out. Let's use yellow red 14.
Bring some orange into it, as I love that red to orange fade.
This makes the color, I don't know, really interesting. I just love it.
I love it. Okay, that's a red, so that is a warm color, so we need to use a warm gray for the shadows. So that neck has dried a bit. Let's try and go back into that neck and salvage a bit of the colors. Seems like nothing new is coming through. It'll have to do then. Let's darken up his gun. I feel like his gun should be darker than his helmet, so let's start with a pretty dark color. Like so. That was a T6, now we're going to do a T4. And then we'll end on a T2. And then a blue 00 to get that copper thing. And then you know what? That was a blue 0000. Or 0000. This is a blue 00. So that's going to make it a bit bluer. Now for the background, we're going to do stars. So let's start with some dark blue. Let's start dark from the top. That was a B97. This is a B95. What about what if where Stola gets a lightsaber? Yeah, that'd be fun. Which is the what if where the Marvel Universe crosses the Star Wars Universe? Gotta love the idea of Doctor Doom fighting Darth Vader, right? And then finally, let's go with a B21. And then we're going to darken this whole thing with a cool color. Let's, because I think that's a bit too summer sky, so space has a bit of black in it. This is a C4. Doomverse Radio would be awesome. So that was a C4. C4 explosive. Let's now do a C5. And then a C6. At the T6. Tippy top. There we go. That's made it darker now, which makes the colors pop more on Star-Lord himself. Now, there's still some little corrections I need to do, like about his eyes. They just don't seem dark enough, so I'm just trying to get some. It's amazing how once these colors dry, they just kind of, they fade so much that the initial colors you put down don't stay as prominent. Maybe it's just the paper I'm using. But I find myself having to go over a lot darker colors, the colors I've already done. Okie dokie, it's... These eyes are not right. These need to be very dark red. Let's do that fully. And then let's go. That's a bit better. And then to even darken the red. Reds are warm, so let's take a warm 7. This went a bit too red, but there is a way to fix that. Second one, I make a bunch of noise. We can take a red colored pencil. Too much. Maybe if I take the white brush pen I have, and go over it, that will make it white again. Red. There we go, that's brought them back. All these little tricks of the trade. Okay, and let's, what are we doing now? Need to probably go back in. Inks to just darken up spots. Definitely need to pop a bit more. So we're adding line weights, making it thicker away from our light source, which is above. I'm no expert at this, I do my best. It must be this paper that removes so much pigmentation, because I see other artists use them. They never have this problem where the inks disappear, but it's kind of a blessing in a sense, because you get a second pass at inking. Yeah, it is kind of cool, because like I said, yeah, you get a second go of figuring out what needs to pop a bit more. To pop. Get a second chance to figure out what is popping and what, of course, is locking, which we refer to as the old pop and lock. Again, I'm just darkening stuff up. Get some gel pen going. Get some reflective in the eyes. Like so. So he looks a bit more alive. Here's my white pencil. Let's take a white colored pencil. We're going over some of the lighter marks on our helmet. To really make the machine a bit more. This also helps sort of get rid of any mistakes you may have made, like on his neck here. I can go back in with the white pencil and lighten up some of these dark stuff. Some of the stuff I thought was a bit too dark. There we go. Like so. That's better. As well. his thingy midbob. Can't think of the name. Strap. And the final touch is the gel pearl around the piece. Oh yeah, that was one thing I wanted to do. I'm gonna make these buttons a different color. That adds a little extra detail. Those buttons are a bit darker, and then we're going to take our colored pencil, a little bit of color for the top bit of them so they shine a bit extra, and then to really make them shine, little dot of the gel pen. This gel pen's not working properly. Oomph, like that. I've lost that color of his hair as well. W6, just we go. I think you can always tell I'm really concentrating when I'm not in the chat. I'm enjoying this, that's what I'm doing. If I'm not engaging, that means I'm pretty much enjoying what I'm doing. It does help to have a co-host on this show, otherwise it is just me concentrating on the art itself. There we go. And now we're going to add some stars, and that will make this really pop. So stars, I'm going to keep it random, like clusters, but I'd like to start with a couple of big stars first. And then we're going to make some of these stars. Thumpf, 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 thumpf. So, and now we're going to add the clusters. So for clusters, I sort of put the pen directly above it. I think this is... gel pen's a bit too full for that. There we go, that's better. Trying to keep them as random as possible. So, and then boom, we now have a guardian in the freaking galaxy. Right, I'm gonna leave this alone. I keep fiddling with it. So thanks very much for watching, guys. I'm sorry I wasn't super chatty. Tomorrow, what's tomorrow? Tomorrow's Thursday. Tomorrow will be another suggestion team, potentially me working on a Venom commission if I can get the basic lines done for it beforehand. And then Friday will be another Obi-Wan Kenobi on my 6 fan arts challenge. So thanks for thank you for watching, everybody. Here is our final piece here. Let me hold it up to the other little camera there. You got yourself a Star-Lord. Make sure you check out my social media for the high-res picture of it. And also, if you want to get a commission from me, please email me at robsonrequest@gmail.com. I will see you guys another time. Goodbye.